Greetings, New Zealand naturopath Eric Backer. I'm author of Candida Crusher and formulator of the CanXida range of dietary supplements. Thanks for checking out my video. I've got a question here from Francois. Francois is in Toulouse. Toulouse is in France, I believe. So it sounds like a French name, Francois. So Francois is asking me, how can I break Candida chitin, or how to break Candida chitin? Francois sent me an email also mentioning a product called Lufenuron that he's been using, and he's been having a few problems with it. So let's just talk a little bit about chitin and candida, chitin synthesis inhibitors and things like this. So it's a pretty dumb idea to think that you can use a product, Francois, that was designed to kill fleas in pets like cats and dogs on human beings. So not many clinical trials, I don't think, have ever been conducted on a product called Lufenuron. And in fact, in a couple of universities in America, when they trialed this against Candida, they found no measurable effects with yeast, you know, as an antifungal agent. So in my mind, it's crazy using products that inhibit chitin of Candida. So chitin really forms part, or major part, of the exoskeleton of insects. So human beings have got skeletons on the inside. Insects, however, like fleas, have a skeleton on the outside. We call it the exoskeleton, and that's comprised of a substance called chitin. So when you inhibit the synthesis of chitin, you know, you stop the production of it, you're going to basically stop the fleas from forming. You're going to, you know, wipe them out pretty quick. So this may be fairly well for fleas, but how can this relate to Candida? Well, it's been found that Candida also have elements of chitin in their cellular membrane, and particularly in components inside Candida are composed of chitin. But it also has been proven that these things initially, you know, when they did initial trials on products like Lufenuron, they found it to, wow, this is amazing. But then they realized it wasn't really working. So all the early enthusiasm was dampened right down. And we know now that it's actually quite useless for yeast infection, but there are still websites peddling these kinds of products. So I want you to be aware of people who make crazy claims of cure and new breakthrough and crap like this, you know. That's the problem with the internet. A lot of people buy into this sort of crap and they think, wow, you know, this is amazing. This brand new invention or brand new discovery is going to cure me. So it doesn't work like that. There are lots of people out there peddling all sorts of junk. So I want you to be careful of products that are labeled as chitin or cell wall suppressors or chitin inhibitors, because they're bullshit. They're complete bullshit. Now, how do I know that? Well, I know that from the thousands of patients I've treated, and particularly the many patients who've contacted me who've been on these chitin inhibitors and who feel like crap. They've been sick. They've had side effects. They've had headaches. And there's a big link now with leaky gut syndrome and these kind of inhibitors. So I want you to be careful. Breaking chitin is a no-brainer. You're not interested in breaking chitin or cell walls when it comes to Candida. I've written many times on my blog, you know, in my articles and on YouTube, I've spoken about it, that you're not really interested. The intelligent person is not really interested in killing Candida. The intelligent person is interested in inhibiting the reproduction of Candida and taking away the food source and changing the environment of the body to stop Candida from getting a foothold, and more importantly, from preventing it from coming back in the future. That's an intelligent person. In my mind, a dumb person is going to walk around with a handgun, try and shoot Candida everywhere from every angle they can to try and kill it, because you're not really learning anything by killing things. You're not really learning how to change, you know, the ways that have contributed to this yeast infection in the first place. All right, it's all about prevention, prevention, prevention. Now, if we can't get into prevention, let's look at an easier way, a less dramatic way of inhibiting reproduction of Candida and starving them and gently eradicating them, not killing them. There's enough killing going on, you know, as it is. So breaking chitin, in my mind, doesn't really work with Candida. Candida are very intelligent organisms. They've got the ability to change from one form to a more invasive form. They've also got the ability to manipulate the immune system around them. They're very clever. They can even create chemicals that can neutralize the immune system. So they can hide, a little bit like viruses. They're very smart little organisms. They can also manipulate products that come into the body that try and change their cell wall. Okay, they become stronger and stronger, more resistant to these things. And there's certainly a link in there with Lufenuron and leaky gut syndrome. So I would not recommend anyone take this product. Okay, I don't care what product you take, but just don't take things that are designed for fleas, for cats and dogs. I mean, it's pretty dumb thinking that you can eradicate a yeast infection by taking a registered flea killer. So don't even go there. So let's forget about breaking Candida chitin. Let's focus more on lifestyle and diet changes to permanently eradicate this monster called Candida so we don't get it back. And if we do, if we are interested in killing it, let's look more at a gentle eradication, not at a kill. All right? Killing gets you nowhere. Killing just creates problems. So I hope that answers your question there in a roundabout way, Francois. And thanks very much for your question.